when these things happen, they don't happen by happenstance. People know who's doing these shootings and who's targeting different people. And for people not to come forward and say, who have done this, looking for retaliation, that's not the way to go.
That is Acting Mayor Jack Young last night on Edmondson Avenue, the 2500 block. Eight people shot, one a 28-year-old man killed, and the victims range in age from 27 to 58. This was at a cookout. We've seen this scene before. We've talked about this scene before.
When you think about the fact that this caps from Friday, 12:01 a.m. through last night, Robert, 17 people shot over the weekend, three homicides. And if you go back to last Monday, it's been a homicide a day from Monday through Sunday. What we have in the city, Robert, are moments in time where 10 days might go by without a homicide. But then we have moments like this where there's an extended period of time of violence. And the question you have to ask, because I know Michael Harrison is just on board, he's implementing his plan, is do we have a comprehensive plan to deal with the long-term nature of this violence?
One of the victims, Juan Grants, a friend of Freddie Gray's, and that happened Saturday night, 4 years to the day since the riots after Gray's
and
funeral.
Since the escalation, Robert, of 300 homicides a year, 700 non-fatal shootings. I went on my show today, talked about the fact in 2014, we had 211 homicides, and that was a bad year. Because the year before, we had 197. We went from 211 homicides and about 350 non-fatal shootings to double both of those numbers, approximately. Something needs to be done to figure out how that happened, how to get us back to those numbers.
See, if we want to turn to Annapolis now, where on Wednesday there's the special session to
elect
a new speaker to replace Mike Bush, who died earlier this month. And now you have a report that Delegate Regina Boyce, delegate, African-American woman from the 40th District, is resigning from the Legislative Black Caucus because Daryl Barnes, the chairman of the committee, said, the chairman of the caucus said, we will not elect a white lesbian as speaker over a black delegate.
My concern about this allegation that Delegate Regina T. Boyce is making, Robert, is that did anybody else go on the record to say this? Because let's be honest about this. Delegate Boyce is supporting Maggie McIntosh. They're from the same legislative district. And I am just questioning the timing of this coming out when, on Friday, if you'll remember, you had Delegate Adrian Jones joining with Delegate Derek Davis to support his candidacy. Now, all of a sudden, there's this commentary coming out accusing the chair of the caucus of some white lesbian comment. The timing is very interesting.
And also, you have the Democratic Party chairman, Myra Rocky Moore Cummings, issuing her letter last week. Threatening letter, retaliation. Delegate Barnes criticized that. She backtracked on it. And also, this weekend, because I follow a lot of delegates on Facebook,
yes,
they were all stating this form letter saying, we will support whoever the Democratic caucus appeals.
Without Republican votes.
Without Republican votes, saying Republican votes undermines the Democratic agenda. Those are basically
McIntosh supporters. We are watching, Robert, a splintering right now within the Democratic Party. And this is one of the concerns people have when you have a long-term speaker serving 16 years and a president of the Senate serving for as long as you have without a succession plan. This is kind of what it comes down to.
One wonders what Mike Bush would have thought of all
my
of this.
My goodness. Thank you, Robert.
C4 show back tomorrow, 9 to 1 on WBAL, News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.